Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today we are playing the TBR Game of Life. We're gonna ignore the fact that I've already squished it. Whoops, mistakes were made. So the TBR Game of Life is my TBR game, and I started it a good while ago, but I think the last time I did it was actually April of 2022. And then I stopped it because of a life slump, and because I had started making a new board and then I stopped because life slump. And so during the month of April, I found it. It's the grand return, I guess. So I think that's all I really have to say about it. So let's get into the spins. Okay, so this is the brand new board. So I'm going to just go through the rules really quickly because it has been like over a year since I've actually done my TBR game. And obviously this is a new board, so we might as well just quickly run through it. I'm not going to go through absolutely every single space on it because we'll see them as the months come, and there's a lot of spaces. So this is based on the Game of Life Adventures Edition, which in that game you have to try and go to all four islands before you retire. And same kind of a deal here, but a little different. So there are two ways for me to finish the game, just like there is in the real Game of Life Adventures Edition. So you can either go to all four of the islands, or you can retire when you spin 10 times. And so the way that I did it the last times was, if I go to all four islands, I win, and if I end up having to retire, then you guys win. And so if that's the case, then I do a giveaway. But last time I won, so it didn't matter. I haven't really thought of like a prize for myself if I do go to all four. I might just like, I kind of have a wish list of like books that I've read and loved that I'm kind of like, that I want to buy to have on my shelf. So I might just like treat myself to one of those. I kind of just save them for like when I have the cash to spend on those. So I might just do that. Or see, I don't want to say, oh, no TBR that month, because like I like having TBRs. So it's like not a reward for me not to have a TBR. So I don't know. If you have any ideas, please tell me. And just like general rules. So at the start of the month, I will spin the spinning wheel to see how many spins I actually have to do. So how many books I have to read. If I land on the same number 3 times, then I have to add a spin to that month. And then also, if I land on the same color 3 times, then I also have to add another spin. Kind of divided some of the prompts into like similar themes, I think. So for example, I have kind of like where I could have gotten them from. So like it's like this light, this kind of a tealy kind of a color, and we have like library, scribd, owned. So like similar theme. And then so we have all of the blanks are pinks, and that means books off my TBR. I have like them on pieces of paper all shuffled. Science fiction, fantasy are all like the light purple colors. Okay, so let's see how many spins I have to do this month. That was a really bad spin, but we'll go with it. A 10. Of course, that's a nice welcome back to my TBR game, isn't it? Oh, anyway, we're gonna just keep going. So spin number 1 of 10. Five. So we can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is a shuffled book off of my TBR. Our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Author's most recent book. Okay, so I'm gonna go with author's most recent book. Spin number 1 of 10, which, great welcome back, was on author's most recent book. And for this, I'm going to go with The Golden Enclaves by Naomi Novik. So, and yeah, this is her most recent book. It came out last year. The paperback is coming out, I think, in either May or June. I think it might be June. And I have the audiobook. I did plan on reading it in April, but I just didn't have the time. And I ended up choosing to read some different sci-fis instead of reading The Golden Enclaves. So I also need to finish this so I can do my ranking Naomi Novik video. So this is my very last one, and it is also her most recent book. So this series follows Elle, and she attends this magical school called the Scholomance. And in this world, these magical children, they attract these monsters called Mals, and so they get sent into this school to learn how to kind of control themselves. But this school is actively trying to kill them, and most of the class won't make it out. Elle has an affinity towards kind of dark magic, but she doesn't actually want to use it, but people kind of get the wrong idea and just assume the worst of her. And this includes the golden boy of the year, Orion, and he kind of starts to follow Elle, and then eventually the two of them end up forming a friendship and end up trying to save people in the school. And I really love the series. It definitely is not for everyone. It has a very interesting writing style. It's very like just stream of consciousness, just word vomit almost, but I personally really enjoy it. It's very much like my style of talking, like going off on a million different tangents. And I really enjoy the characters, and I'm excited and nervous to finally get to the last book. So that is book number one. So then spin number 2 of 10. And that's 2. 1, 2. So that is going to be a random book off of my TBR. So spin number 2 was a blank, and this is actually one of the prompts that I have, kind of questions, I want your opinions. Obviously, if you have any sort of rules that you think would be fun to add, you can leave them down below, but this is kind of the main one. And so when I first started the game, I used to do it like with the Game of Life. So on the wheel, there is red and black spaces in by the colors. I can't remember which is which, whether the odd is red and the even is, you know. But either way, so, and I used to have little cards that would have a book that I want to read or a book that I don't. And then I would spin, and whichever color I landed on, I had to read that book. And then I switched it up, and the cards only had books on my physical TBR. And now I just have a jar. So do you want me to bring back like the spinning, the cards for them? And do you want it to be just like my physical TBR? Do you want it to be like prompts that you suggest? Do you want it to be books that you suggest? Anything like that, I would be really intrigued to know. I'm kind of leaning towards going back to the cards, but I'm not sure what way I kind of want to do it, whether I want it to be books on my physical TBR or just random books. Okay, so they're all kind of in here. I probably should have folded them into quarters, not halves, because I think it would be easier to grab them. Okay, I can do this one because I want to read this book for a video anyway, so it works out. And that is Middle Game by Shauna McGuire. So Middle Game by Shauna McGuire, I've had this on my TBR for almost a year now because Christy got it for my birthday last year, and I really need to read it. Hint at the video that I want to include it in. I want to read my past book hauls again. You know, volume 2 coming, and my birthday is in May, so obviously I hauled a lot of books last year. So this follows Roger and Dodger, who are twins, but they've been separated at birth, and the man who is like raising them is trying to basically raise them to godhood. And I think one of them is really skilled with language and words, and the other one is really skilled with maths. And then I think they keep kind of coming together even though they're not supposed to be, and as I said, something about raising them to godhood. And I'm really intrigued. I know that it's supposed to be weird, so I'm excited to see what the fuss is about. Spin number 3. Four, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh God, already another pink. A book off my physical TBR, so. And I can't get another pink. Great, this is great. Spin number 3 was another blank, so we got the jar back. Yeah, I don't actually have that many pieces of paper in here, so I really gotta reach in. Okay. All right, I can work with this. So this is The Shadow Glass by Rin Shapeckel. So The Shadow Glass, as I said, is the third and final book in the Bone Witch trilogy, and I actually only read the second book last month, and I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. I gave the first one a 4, the second one a 3, and I'm hoping this one will be good for me. I definitely left too much time between the first and the second one, which was my bad, but I think I'm like back to like, I really am like back to connecting with the world and all of this. And again, Rin Shapeckel was another author that I want to do a ranking all of their books, and I still have a good few left to go, so I know I have Silver Under the Nightfall, which I'm waiting for the paperback to come out, because like I want to own it, because like I have a good feeling about it. Like I have a feeling I'll love it. I'm not sure has this, I know the second book has been released in the Wicked As You Wish series, but I'm not sure has the third one been yet, but I think that's it. So I'm getting close. And this series follows T, and she's a bone witch, which means she can like raise the dead and control them. And so she gets sent away to learn how to control this magic. And we flash forward to her time with this like scribe who is like writing down her story. And so we know like something bad has happened, but we don't know how we get there. Spin number 4. Five. So one, three, two. I can go either over here, or over here. So let me think. Also, I just realized I should probably actually put like arrows that show which way I'm going, because I will probably forget what way I've started going.
I'll do that afterwards.
So we're gonna go one. That one counts as one, by the way, because it's the same spot. Two, three, four, five. So adult fantasy, and I get this.
Spin number four was an adult fantasy, and for this I'm going to go with Before They Are Hanged by Joe Abercrombie, and this is the Catch Up Book Club book. So they're doing First Law Along, and I am obviously participating, and I think it's like the first Sunday in the month, so I will be reading this in like the first-ish week of May. So it'll be read pretty soon, and I'm intrigued as to how this story is going to continue, because there was not a lot of plot in the first book, and so I'm hoping that there will be a lot more in this one. Basically, this series follows three main points of views, though I think maybe there might be another one in here. So the first book mostly just focuses on them as people and what their lives are like and what the world is like. And we follow Glockta, who is a torturer. He used to be a really well-respected person in the military, and then he got captured, he got tortured, and then when he came back, he himself became a torturer. And then we also follow Giselle, and he is almost in a position like Glockta was a couple of years ago. He is like a fencing champion, but he is rich and is part of the nobility, and he kind of has everything handed to him. And then we also follow again, and he is actually from a different part of the world, and he, in very early on in the book, comes across this magical person, and he ends up kind of getting dragged along by this person into some kind of quest nearly.
Number five. That's another four. Okay, so four. And I cannot get another five or another four, or else I have to add a spin. This is not going well. One, two, three, four. Somebody else's TBR game.
So spin number five is TBR game. So Mel has put up her TBR, and it has a new board and everything. I'll leave the video and her channel link down below. And I have actually already watched it, so I'm gonna just watch the first little bit again. Okay, so chapter titles. Oh my god, actually I think I do actually have a book for this. I'm gonna hold this up and you're not gonna judge me. Okay, because I have exams in May and I'm stressed and I want to read this. Okay, so you're not gonna say anything. So for chapter titles, thanks Mel, I'm going to read Clockwork Angel by Cassandra Clare. So basically I'm thinking of doing a vlog where I reread a couple of favorites just like during the first like 2 weeks while my exams are going on, so I don't actually have to like put the effort into reading new books. But I do want to reread the entire Infernal Devices, so you're gonna be okay with that?
Yeah.
Also, look how battered and bruised this copy is. Like, geez. And look at those pages. They nasty. Yeah. Just well loved, some might say. This book follows Tessa Gray, and she arrives in Victorian England because her aunt has died and her brother has sent for her. And so she arrives in Victorian England, and she gets taken to this house, and very strange things are happening, and then she gets rescued shadow hunters, and she ends up going to the London Institute and becoming very close to all of the shadow hunters that are there. And this is one of my favorite series of all time. Don't at me. This is teenage. This is teenagehood. And I love it.
Spin number five, six.
Seven.
One, two, three, four. Five, six, seven. Big book.
Spin number six is going to be a big book, and for me, big book is over 500 pages. And so for this, I'm going with Clockwork Princess by Cassandra Clare. This is book three, because book two is 494 pages, which is very annoying to me. But this one is like 540, so we're good. This is a big book. Third and final book in the Infernal Devices trilogy. So it's happening. I'm rereading.
Spin number seven. Oh, I have to add another spin. One, two, three, four. Okay, at least I can move again.
I'm gonna go over here. And I get this. And that's been Is Fictional Country.
So then we landed on Fictional Country, and for this I'm going to be reading Night Shadow by Sebastian de Castell, which is the second book in the Greycoat series. I actually read the first one last year in April for Bruntathon, I'm pretty sure. And so it's been a year. I feel like though I actually remember things that happened pretty well. Tristia is the name of the nation. So basically the Greycoats used to be like these elite warriors who used to work specifically for the king. And then the king was killed and he gave them all a final duty. And some of them are very secret about what it is. Some can tell others. And Falkio has been searching for his this whole time. And I know that most people think that this is the best book in the series. So I'm excited.
Bin number 8 of 11. That's another 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Phone a friend.
So then spin number 8 was phone a friend. And for this, I messaged Emma and I will leave her Instagram link down below. And Emma gave me 3 recommendations. And so I went on my library app and scribed and I was having a nosy. And the 3 that she recommended were Furies of Calderon, which is Codex Alera, book 1. Then A Discovery of Witches or The Goblin Emperor. And I ended up going with The Goblin Emperor. And this book I'm intrigued about, but also kind of nervous to read. So I've heard that it is very slow, political, but like not a lot going on really. And I'm like, this could really work for me or this could maybe not really work for me. I know Cassidy didn't love it. And I think she was just like overall bored. And see, that scares me a little. Because me and Cassidy, we tend to agree on feelings about books. As in, we would be like, okay, I didn't like this thing about it. I didn't like that thing. I like this thing about it. I didn't like this thing. We will be like that, but then we will give vastly different ratings because we just have different preferences. So when she's saying like nothing happens in it, I'm like, okay, I will probably think nothing happens in it, but that doesn't mean I won't enjoy it.
Bin number 9. Released after 2015.
The next prompt that I have is released after 2015. And for this, I'm once again going for another reread. That's going to be Radio Silence by Alice Oseman. So this was released in 2016 and it's one of my favorite books of all time, or at least that's what I always say. I used to reread it every single year, but I didn't reread it last year because I was afraid I wasn't going to like it. And right now I'm going to reread it. But also I feel like it might be a really bad idea because I'm doing my final exams, and a big focus on this book is that our character kind of like feels like she doesn't really know what she's doing with her life. And I kind of feel like that right now. So I'm like, it could be a sensitive subject. So that could either work in its favor or work against it. But I do really want to reread this. This follows Frances, and Frances is a study machine. She is the top of her class. She has been working her entire life to get into her dream university to study her dream degree. And then she ends up becoming friends with Alad Last. And for the first time, she's not trying to hide behind this like perfect persona that she has made. And she gets to be herself and be creative and fun and free. And it's really just about the two of them and their friendship and how their pressures of being good in school can affect you and what you want to do in the future. And I just love it a lot.
Spin number 10, which was supposed to be my last spin. Three. Okay, I think that's a safe number.
Yeah, that's a safe number.
1, 2, 3. Owned.
Then spin number 10 is going to be a book that I own, and for this I'm going with The Swordsman's Lament by GM White. And again, this is another one that I got for my birthday last year, as you can see from the gift note that was sticking at the bottom. It was from Cassidy. I read the first 20 pages because it was supposed to be included in a vlog last year that never ended up happening. It was the same vlog that I read the Mind Death series and Desperate Measures for, and then I never went anywhere with that vlog. So I read those books for no reason. But basically the point of that vlog was I was going to read stuff that Cassidy told me to read. Some jokingly and some not so jokingly. Cassidy really liked it last year when she read it. I think she gave it a 4 stars, like a really high 4 star.
and it follows the royal champion, and he's like an epic swordsman, and the, I think, is it either the king or the prince? The prince is killed, and he gets blamed for it, and so he has to kind of go and prove that it wasn't him. So it's kind of like a little bit of a murder mystery.
Then spin number 11, hopefully our last spin. Please be our last spin. Nine. Okay, that's a safe number.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay, 9. Another phone a friend.
And so then our 11th and final rule was another phone a friend prompt. And this time I sent a message to Maria. And I will leave Maria's channel link down below. And Maria recommended me two books. Well, first she recommended one book and then she's like, oh, but maybe this one. And then she went with one book. So she was trying to choose between The Sword of Kaigen and Jade City, and she ended up going with The Sword of Kaigen by Emma Wang, which is honestly a pretty good thing because, once again, another birthday gift from Cassidy. I'm very sorry, Cassidy. I have not read any of the presents you got me. I was planning on reading in April, but then Emma came to the rescue and gave me a smaller book with clouds on the cover. I feel like I will like this. I feel like it's literally been on my TBR for years. Like, okay, it's only been on my physical TBR for like 1 year, but it's been on like my mind TBR for like 3. I know that it follows this family, and they live on a very like remote part of the world, and they are very cut off from society, and they live very traditional lives. And the mother of this family used to actually not live here and be like, she was a fighter and everything, and then she retired and came and lived a very traditional lifestyle where she's like the perfect mother and all of that. And then I think, and so she's had her kids and all of this, and I think war starts to come, and the son wants to fight, and then I think eventually the mother ends up joining in. So those are all 11 books that are on my physical CBR. I'm gonna have to see if I can get a couple audiobooks, because like that's not happening. I do technically have other books that I would like to read. But I have a feeling that they're not going to happen because this is a lot. Well, one of them has to happen for one of the books on my TBR to happen. So obviously I also have to add Clockwork Prince to the mix, because if this doesn't happen, then Clockwork Princess can't happen. So this is going to be red. And then the other two that I kind of had on my TBR was going to be Lost Boy by Christina Henry, which would be another reread for me. And then the other one, again, like I actually own these books physically, but I'm too lazy to go get them. And the other one is A Promise of Blood, which is literally there, but I have a load of stuff piled on top of it. And so this was supposed to be the Backlist Book Club pick for March and April, I think. And then the live show was supposed to be in early May, but Cassidy got like 70 pages into it, was not enjoying it. Mel finished the book, I think she gave it 2 stars. And I got about 60 pages in and I wasn't really enjoying it. And I kind of was like, I don't think it's going to be above a 3 stars. Like, I'm intrigued and I will definitely continue because I don't really read ENF books, but I'm like, okay, with live show not happening. So the live show ended up getting cancelled. We're not continuing that series. But as I said, I do still want to read it. But like, obviously with all the books on my TBR, this might be the month where it happens. Also, I'm not really planning on participating in any readathons, but 72 Hours in the Smut Den is happening in May and it's like the end of the month. And I might try and read like 2 books for it. So like one from the light wheel, one from the dark. But like, it'll be very low-key. I'm not gonna be like really participating in it, so we'll see. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.